It is time for CarPlay to go wireless with the Pioneer AVH-W4400NEX. Hey everyone, it is Andrew here from AppleInsider. Today we are going to be talking about CarPlay. We have had CarPlay in our vehicles for some time, but it's been wired, and which is not really ideal. You're kind of stuck with that cable in there. You can't use wireless charging in the car. Just not a great solution. We've been waiting for manufacturers to add wireless to the vehicles, just standard, but it's not really happening, not happening fast enough. So we went aftermarket, we picked up the Pioneer AVH-W4400NEX. It is a double DIN 7-inch touchscreen with wireless CarPlay and wireless Android Auto. So we are gonna get that installed, we're gonna throw it in our car, and we're going to give you a rundown of what to expect and why really wireless CarPlay is absolutely the way to go. So as we said, this is a 7-inch resistive touchscreen with a resolution of 800 by 480 at a 16 by 9 aspect ratio. There are a ton of details to get into with this thing, but we're going to keep it at a somewhat high level and focus primarily on how this works with Apple CarPlay. So we did get this installed in our Chevy Cruze, and so far it's been amazing. This is such a step up from a wired CarPlay experience, which we've shown off a bunch in our Ford Escape. A few things you're going to notice is with wired, you do get the battery status on the left-hand side. The resistive screen is extremely responsive to our touches. We haven't had any lag whatsoever in the actual interface. Maybe small imperceptible ones, but that's more from the wireless streaming from your phone rather than the actual responsiveness of the touchscreen. There are physical controls along the bottom for controlling things like the volume, which is obviously very handy to have on a radio. Tapping the center button takes you to the main overview of the screen. On that lower left-hand corner is where you can control Apple CarPlay, including switching devices. You can see both my phone and my fiance's phone here. We can easily switch between the two if we both happen to be in the car. Mine was first on the list, so if we're both in the vehicle, it does jump to mine before hers. Tapping that AV button there on the right brings up all the other controls you can go through. There's obviously dual camera inputs for this thing, forward and backward. There are gauges for the car. You can see tire pressures for the Chevy Cruze. Tons of other information that you can kind of dig into. Stuff that's already available in your car. This used to be kind of on the HUD behind the steering wheel, but it's also viewable now here as well, which is great if you have two people in the car and you're trying to have them look something up while you're driving. One of the questions we had with wireless was how responsive it's going to be whenever you make a change. So we did notice that as soon as you make a change, open an app, play pause music, that reacts instantly. You can see that play pause happening in real time, but there is about a 1 second delay oftentimes for the music to actually react. So I hit play or pause on my phone, the screen changes right away, but then there is about a second before the actual music or the audio catches up. It's small, but it is noticeable. We absolutely love the AVH-W4400NEX. It is extremely responsive, it's wonderful to use, and wireless CarPlay is for sure the way to go. We can now use wireless chargers and don't have to be tethered to our vehicle every time. If you are able to, we highly recommend upgrading to this wireless CarPlay receiver. You can find it at the link below in the description, and let me know what you think on Twitter at @Andrew_OSU. Hey everyone, did you guys like that video? Be sure to click on that like button so we can create content that we know that you guys want to see. And follow Apple Insider on all social media channels. If you want the best prices on any Apple gear, check out the Apple Insider Price Guide that is updated daily. And until next time, we'll see you later.